let's jump to our third step, which is creation of Angular application. So in this step, we are going to create the Angular app. I have created Angular app by sample Angular app by Angular CLI, where you have to put a command like ng new and your project name. So that command I will give you in description, or you can Google it, you will be able to get that. So here my main focus is on deployment, not on Angular project and or backend project. So we will create a simple Angular project where we will be having one input box to enter the product name, and we will put that product in our DB and will show that products on the UI page when we refresh the page. So I have created this Heroku UI demo Angular project. In that you will able to see the screen, like if you I have run this project, so it has been started on localhost 4200. So let's open this page. Yes, if you hit this, yeah, we have current successfully started our Angular app. So we will remove this all the component, and we'll keep put on this simple input box which we use for inserting data. So if we go into Angular project, yeah, in this app dot component.html file, we have all this information. So we will put only simple div and input box. So we will give name as a product name. Then, like here, we will use ng models, like a simple taking the input information and putting into DB. So again, I'm not mentioning like form, directory form and all. We'll simply put the ng model. Enter product name. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, here we are able to see the screen where we need to put the product name, like product 1 and 2. We will put one more submit button. So I have added one submit button here. To make development fast, I have did this in offline. So then we are going to paste the product list from backend, and we are showing product ID and the product name. So to paste that data from the backend, we need the HTTP client. So for that, I have added the HTTP client in our constructor. Then we need a product list, so I have created a product component, product.ts, where we have ID and name. Then on environment variable, we have set the server URL where localhost colon 8080. And if there is a one prod variable, so here you can mention when you are deploying to the pod. That we will see in subsequent steps. So first we will run this in locally, and then we'll test. I will show you how the screen currently looks like. And yeah, so here we are printing the ID and name, and enter the product name. If you enter the product name, it will store in DB. So let's start for writing post method. I will write this in, let's move this in little fast.